decide that A, it is not constitutionally required, and B, it is not a useful tool.
But there's other times when he sounds very much like many of the black leaders in Wilmington who say, I don't know if I like this remedy, but I do know that the issue of immigration is really important. So he's kind of firmly in the middle. Mm-hmm. And that kind of middle ground is something we see him stake on a number of issues, most notably crime, where he takes the kind of position and relies on those personal relationships with black communities, while, according to his critics, legislating in the interests of black communities.
Same spot. Launch workout. She's going to be in one more month, I think she'll be almost as tall as those girls. At this rate.
Yeah, she's gotten so tall. I mean, she's only been here, what, 5 weeks
or something? Yeah. She fit right in.
They end up passing a really kind of significant set of bills.
Not enough prosecutors to convict them, not enough judges to sentence them, and not enough prison cells to put them away for a long time.
In 1984, it establishes mandatory minimums.
Do we have a lot of meetings today? Hey, Chloe! Look at that little trot! Look at that!
Thank you, Mr. Vice President, for your introduction and for your labors on this bill.
The three strikes and you're out kind of policy.
Three strikes and you're out will be the law of the land.
If you had three instances of drug offenses, violent drug offenses, it would be an instant life sentence.
We have the tools now. Let us get about the business of using them.
And what do we understand
about these tough crime measures at the time.